Yes. Yes. Look, I saw... Could you just stop talking for 1 minute? I saw Selma the other day. She was with her boyfriend or whatever he was. I'm not sure what he was to her. I'll just be a second. Okay, just stop yelling. Stop. Hung up on me. Well, that was inappropriate. I'm sorry to bring you into my personal life. Hardly professional.
We all have our weak moments.
That we do, yes. Okay, so, your name again?
Birgail. B-I-R-A. And gale as in gale force wind.
And who did you say referred you?
That technique used in your profession? Put words in your patient's mouth.
So if you weren't referred by anyone, how is it you came to get an appointment with me?
There you go again. What else do you know about me?
Nothing. I know nothing except your name. Vera, would you like to tell me what's bothering you?
That's what everyone says. Everyone. All they know is my name, nothing else. It's like I don't exist, like I'm invisible.
It's not uncommon to feel this way, particularly in the uncertain world we live in.
Oh, so now you're saying I'm not special? That I'm just like everybody else? That I'm common and typical? That I'm fungible? Is that what you're saying? I'm fungible?
Vera.
You were talking to your husband?
Excuse me?
When you were on the phone before. You were talking to your husband, Dr. Dexter Dunzel. Selma. Beautiful but imperfect Selma. Fragile. Delicate. Like glass. She's not your real daughter.
Okay. Okay,
you had trouble getting pregnant. So you had a procedure arranged by Dexter. Remember? Remember how you trusted him with everything to implant the egg that he fertilized with his sperm? Except what you didn't know. It wasn't your egg.
Tell Dexter to go fuck himself!
Dexter doesn't know I exist. Remember?